Welcome back to accounting session once again. Today we will see one more problem based on revaluation account with different adjustments than that we have learned in our previous session. So today we will see one more problem based on revaluation account. X and Y are partners. Sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 6:4. The balance sheet as on 31/3/2018 was as follows. Between $50,000 machinery, $40,000 furniture, $30,000 cash, $20,000 they decided to admit himself as a new partner on the following terms. He has to bring ₹50,000 as capital for 150 share in future profits and ₹10,000 for goodwill. The assets and liabilities were revalued as follows. Building is valued at 10% more than the book value. Furniture, machinery is valued at 15% less than the book value. Maintain RDD at 10% on debtors. Investment is revalued at ₹12,000. So this is the question. So here we are supposed to focus only on the revaluation account. And remaining all amount you will see in the further process. Now you will just focus on preparation of revaluation account. In revaluation account, all these other information are not concerned here. Only the value of assets and liabilities should be considered here. You will consider one more adjustment. Unclaimed creditors, ₹2,000. Should be written off. So these are the adjustments, and let us see one by one. Building, here it is 50,000, and in the adjustment it is mentioned that the building is valued at 10% more than the book value. So the book value is 50,000. 50,000 10% is 5,000. 5,000 will be the increase in the value of building. So you show it on the credit side of the revaluation account because increase in the value of asset. Machinery is 40,000. Machinery is valued at 15% less than the book value. So 40,000 15% equal to 6,000. So 6,000 will be minus 6,000. So next is furniture. No information is given as to the furniture. So furniture will remain same. So there is no increase or decrease in the value of furniture. So it will not shown in the revaluation account. Next, cash. Cash is not concerned because cash cannot be valued. Investments. Investment was rupees 10,000 and now it is revalued at 12,000. So 12,000 means there is an increase of 2,000 plus 2,000. That is, it should be credited or in the revaluation account. Next, debtors. They are asked to maintain the RDD at a 10% on debtors. So this is the book value of debtors, 42,000. So 42,000 already RDD is provided at rupees 2,000. Now in this problem, they are asking it to provide for doubtful debts or reserve for doubtful debts at 10% on debtors. So debtors is 42,000. So 10% of that is 4,200. Already RDD is 2,000. So 2,200 has to be debited in the revaluation account because RDD should be provided at how much? 10% of the book value is 42,000. 10% of that is 4,200. Already RDD is 2,000. Now in this year you also have to pay RDD of 2,200. So let us solve this problem now. We will prepare one revaluation account now. Revaluation account. And last one is unclaimed creditors. You are recorded in your books creditors of rupees 2000 and it has been carried forward for many years, but the creditors are not claiming that money, so it should be written off in this year. So this will be add or else decrease in liability, so it should be credited. It should be credited to the revaluation account. If the creditors are not claiming the money that you owe to your creditors and if you are writing off that, it will be credited to the revaluation account. So let us solve this problem now. Debit and credit. Particulars. Amount. First one is building is valued at 10% more than the book value. So 50,000 is the value of building. So building is increased to 5,000. So 5,000. 50,000 into 10% is equal to 5,000. Machinery is 15% less. So decrease in the value of asset. This is increase in the value of asset 5,000. This is decrease in the value of asset. To machinery. It will be 6,000. 15% is reduced in the value of machinery. Maintain RDD at 10% on debtors. So book value, you should calculate the RDD on always book value. Book value is 42,000. So 42,000, 10% is equal to 4,200. Already RDD is at 2,000. Now you are supposed to create RDD at rupees 2,200 to debtors. RDD is 2200. Now investment is revalued at rupees 12,000. It was 10,000 previously. There is increase in the value of asset by investments. 2000. Next, unclaimed creditors. Creditors means the persons to whom you owe money. So if you are owing money and the creditor is not claiming it since long period, 4-5 years, and you are carrying forward that creditors from year to year, and if you find that they are not claiming that, you can write off that, and if you write off that, it will be shown on the credit side, unclaimed creditors. That is 2000. So here 9000 on the credit side, on debit side it is 8200. So to X capital account, remaining will be the profit. So profit is 1800. 1800 into 6 by 10. So 0 0, thank you.